Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Sharmin. Today I'm gonna talk about GM food. Okay, so let's get started. Genetically modified animals for food production are much rarer than crop plants. An example is the GM Atlantic salmon developed in the USA and Canada, a growth hormone regulating gene from a Pacific Chinook salmon and a promoter from another species of fish. An ocean port were injected into a fertilized egg of an Atlantic salmon. By producing growth hormone throughout the year, the salmon are able to grow all year and instead of just in spring and summer. So as a result, fish reach market size is in about 18 months compared with the 3 years needed by an unmodified fish. Okay, so yeah, and it is proposed to rear only sterile females and to farm, okay, them in land-based tanks. And the characteristics of GM salmon reduce their ability to compete with wild salmon in a natural environment, and this has led the US Food and Drug Administration, that means FDA, to declare that they are highly unlikely to have any significant effects on the environment and as safe as food as conventional Atlantic salmon. Okay, so in 2013, Canada approved the production of GM salmon eggs on a commercial scale, but neither Canada nor the US FDA had yet given permission for GM salmon to enter the human food chains. Okay, so yeah. So now I'm gonna talk about social implications of using genetically modified organisms in food production. Okay, so let's get started. Some genetically modified plants are grown in strict containment in glass houses, but a totally different set of problems emerge when genetically engineered organisms such as crop plants and organisms from the biological control of pests are intended for use in the general environment. Okay, so can such organisms be used safely? And well, it might seem like that a few countries would object to the growth of genetically modified crops that produce vaccines for human or animal use, yet there are people who object to the growth of pro-vitamin A enhanced rice. Okay, so however, most objects are raised against the growth of herbicides resistance or insect resistance crops. The concerns about these genetically modified crops are as follows. Number one, the modified crop plants may become agricultural weeds or invade natural habitats. And number two, the introduced gene may be transferred by pollen to wild relatives, whose hybrid offspring may become more invasive. Okay, so yeah, introduced gene may be transferred by pollen to unmodified plants and growing on a farm with organic certification. Organic certification, the modified plants may be a direct hazard to human, domestic animals or other beneficial animals. Okay, so by being toxic or producing allergies, and the herbicide that can now be used to the crop will leave toxic reducing in the crops. Okay, so genetically modified seeds are expensive as is herbicide, and their cost may remove any advantage of growing a resistant crop. Okay, so next one, this one, growers mostly need to buy seed each season, keeping cost high, and unlike for traditional varieties where the grower kept seed from one crop to sow for the next. And next one, in the part of the world where a lot of genetically modified crops are grown, there is a danger of losing traditional varieties with their desirable background genes for particular locations and their possible unknown trait that might be useful in a world where the climate is changing. So yeah, and these requires a program of growing and harvesting traditional varieties and setting up a seed bank to preserve them. Okay, so yeah, so despite these concerns, there are now millions of hectares of genetically modified crops and trees growing across the world. And in the USA in 2011, half cotton crops and more than half maize and soy crops and were genetically modified, and significant areas of China, Brazil and India are used for these crops, and farmers in developing countries are adopting the products of gene technology with enthusiasm. The exception in Europe with its careful but strict controls, but Europe also has well-organized groups of protesters. Almost all of the field trials of genetically modified crops and that have taken place in the UK. Okay, so yeah, and during the last 10 years have been vandalized, but there are any damaging effects human societies of genetic technology, or have any of the theoretical hazards had an actual effect on human societies? Well, there is little evidence of gene escaping into the wild, and superweed has appeared to reduce crop growth. There are no examples of food produced from genetically modified organisms unexpectedly turning out to be toxic or allergenic, and unless the known effects of genetically modified crops become much greater than have so far been measured, the effect on human societies may be said to be small but positive, and there are though possible effects that cannot yet be measured, such as the future consequence of any loss of biodiversity from growing GM crops. So guys, that's all. Thank you for watching.